Yo!
What's up? This is Patrick.
And Zoe.
And in this video, we're going to talk about the new dynamic format string for measures, Power BI Desktop. Zoe, it's your first time on Guy in the Cube.
It is my first time.
Welcome. Before we get going, do me a favor. Tell everybody who you are and what you do.
Sure. So my name is Zoe Douglas, and I'm a product manager for Power BI.
All right. In the recent release, I was looking at this thing called Dynamic Format String for Measures. And I was really excited about it. I told Adam I'm going to do a video. I said, you know what? Why would I do the video when we could get you, the creator of this feature, yes, I say creator, to come on live and do this with us. So thank you so much. So tell us about these dynamic format strings.
So if you're familiar with calculation groups,
yep,
they already have dynamic format strings on the calculation items. They're optional, but it's one way if you have to flip between a currency or a percentage. You can do so in a DAX expression, so you can have it conditionally format based off of, say, a slicer selection or something else in your model. So you can indicate to it which one you want to use. So now we're bringing that and putting it on an individual measure. So this way you don't have to set up a calculation group, which can have pretty wide impact on all your measures. This way you can actually just limit this down to a single measure.
So I can get really specific. So
exactly.
So enough of all this talk. You know how we like to do? So what are you going to show us, right?
Yes.
So instead of all this talking, let's head over to our laptop.
So one of the common scenarios for this is actually currency conversion, right? So here in my model, I already have defined the countries I want to convert to, and I have those format strings also listed here. So when they pick a trader, they're going to use the appropriate format string.
Yeah.
So here I have my converted sales amount measure already defined. And now to add this dynamic format string to it, I just go into this dropdown, click dynamic. It's going to give me the actual format string that was used before, just so I can have something to start with. But I can just go ahead and paste in that selected value from that table. And now when I select this country, it's going to go ahead and use the correct format string, not only in the table, but also in the visual.
Wow. And it's pretty simple. I saw your table that you created, and I was impressed that you had all the different currency formats, but I don't know these things. And I'm sure somebody's out there is like, oh, I can scrape this from a web page or something like that. Is there a way to do this a little more seamlessly?
So the other limitation, of course, with this is that this is still in the English locale, right?
Yep.
Some currencies like to use the period for the thousand separator and the comma for the decimal separator. And so this won't capture that either. So there is another way you can do this using that format function. So the format function, when used in a measure, will actually make that measure output as a text, mm-hmm. which makes it difficult for this because then you can't use it in visuals. It's great for titles, subtitles, sure. and cards and stuff like that. But when you use it now with the dynamic format strings with measures, you can actually get around that limitation and still keep that new optional parameter that they have, which is to provide the locale. And then it will figure out the format string for you.
That's pretty nice. You show us.
Yes, I'll show
you. Let's take a look.
So over here, I have the same converted sales amount, and I have it with this locale. And I already have it supplied, so just let me just go ahead and show you what this one looks like. So here, what I'm doing is I'm actually passing it the locale. So I have those up here in the slicer with the selected measure, which is the measure that this dynamic format string is on. And it's just saying convert it to the appropriate currency for this locale. So it's very easy. So the tricky part about this is it's not going to pass back the format string to be applied by the dynamic format string. It's going to actually apply it to the measure, and then we're going to return it kind of as a string literal on the measure. So now here you can see that I have passed the format function, the selected measure, said come back as a currency using the locale that I provided. And now because it's actually converted the measure already with the format string, I'm going to actually return it as a string literal. So that's why I'm wrapped it in these single quotes as well.
Gotcha. And so now when I choose those locales from that slicer that you have up there, it'll just automatically switch to that currency.
Correct. So if I go to this one here, I can see the US, right? I can go to Japan. And then Brazil is the interesting one because this is where you're going to see that we have those commas and the period switched. And you can see it already switched those in the table, in the visual, in any of them. So it's really great.
All right. So what do you think? Are you using dynamic format strings? Are you going to leave those calc groups and come over to dynamic format string for measures, or like Adam calls them, string magic? I don't know. Right. But if you have any questions, comments, or any ideas, you want to chat it up with Zoe and I, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to learn more about data modeling, check out the data modeling playlist that's flying over my head. And as always, from Adam
and Zoe
and Patrick, thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.